Hello everyone, this is Pattu from FreeFinCal, and in this video let's consider what is meant by asset allocation and how to use it in our investment strategy. So when we used to go out on vacations, or when I used to go out alone, my mother used to say, don't keep all your money in the same place, or don't keep it all in your shirt pocket, put some in your back pocket, put some in your bag, and so on. So distribute the money. The reason was she feared that if my pocket was picked, then I lose all my money, or if I lost my bag in which I had all my money, then I would be in real trouble. So that was a simple way to spread money in different areas so that we lower the risk of losing it. So asset allocation is essentially the same idea, not putting all eggs in one basket, as they call it. So what is asset allocation? First, we need to decide where to invest. That is, which asset classes we should choose for investing: equity, fixed income, gold, real estate, and so on. For most purposes, equity and fixed income is more than enough, so we'll consider only that. So example of equity is, of course, stocks, directly buying stocks, or you can use equity mutual funds. Example of fixed income, the employee provident fund, a voluntary contribution to that employee provident fund, PPF, fixed deposits, recurring deposits, all debt mutual funds, any bond that you buy, corporate deposits, they're all examples of fixed income. So once you decide where you're going to invest, let's say in equity and fixed income, then you must ask, how much are you going to invest in equity? How much am I going to invest in fixed income? And once you decide the asset class, and you the next step is finding out how much you invest. This is called asset allocation. That is, you're saying, I'm going to invest 50% in equity and 50% in fixed income, or I'm going to invest 20% in fixed income or 80% in equity, is called asset allocation. But how do you decide? The first is to have a return expectation from equity and fixed income for the period you're going to invest. The return expectation will depend on the period you're going to invest. Then you should have a risk expectation for the period you're going to invest. How much should I expect my portfolio to move up and down? And how long will it remain down if it falls? For example, I have done a recent study and shown that if you use 60% equity, you should expect at least 60 to 65% fall in the portfolio, entire portfolio, not just equity, and it will remain down for as long as 2 years. For 40% equity, expect 50% fall. For 70% equity, expect 75-80% fall. So that's the kind of fall in the portfolio that you should expect. So the risk is high if you use higher equity, and higher risk does not always mean higher return. And then I would expect about 10 to 12% return from equity after tax for about 10 years, and a little below 10% for below 10 years. And as I've discussed in a recent video, the link is in the description box, for any goal within 5 years, use 100% fixed income. So that's your asset allocation: 0% equity and 100% fixed income. For goals between 5 to 10 years, I would recommend an asset allocation of 90 to 70% fixed income and the rest in equity. And for goals above 10 years, I would recommend an asset allocation of 60 to 40% fixed income and 40 to 60% equity. And please note that these are the initial allocations in equity. You cannot hold that much equity right until you need money, or because it will be too risky and fluctuate too much. So the third step is to have a plan to reduce equity in a stepwise manner as you start investing. So this is the place you start investing, and then you kind of go down and taper it down to zero. So once you have those steps in place, let's say I expect 12% post-tax from equity. I'm a slightly aggressive investor. I expect 12%. 10% will be better, but 12% is reasonable, I think. And 6% post-tax return from fixed income. And I decide to have 60% of equity in my portfolio. So the expected portfolio return would be 12% of equity into 60%, which is the exposure, plus 6% into 40%. So that's a weighted sum, and that's about 9.6% after tax. Now, this is for the first year or the first few years. Asset allocation will change later. So you need to, when the asset allocation changes, the expected portfolio return will also change, typically come down because the equity is coming down. So you need to take that into account, and you need to calculate the monthly investment to be made for all asset allocation in every year of investing. So you can do this automatically using my robo advisory template, and I hope I've tried to explain what asset allocation is in this video. So you can go to freefincal.com, and in the main menu you will see a free robo advisory link. You can go there and download this robo advisory file. This is an exe file. You cannot change the internal settings. The exe file is free to use. You can set in your goal, and it will automatically tell you the asset allocation you need and how the asset allocation should be changed for every year of investing, and what is the amount you need to invest, and how much to invest in equity, and how much to invest in fixed income. So that's what asset allocation means. Catch you again in another video. Bye bye.